Thank you, Scott, and thank you for taking this time for having us here. So I'm Venice, and I'm working on rice research for AB. So I've been talking about rice galaxy. So the common use case, so I joined Yuri. When I joined Yuri, I was hired as a web applications developer. And people come to me and said, I have this software that's running a command line, and could you make like a graphical user interface for me? So usually that's the use case or the features that most people want for me to do. So yeah, most open source and free bioinformatics software, they really run typically in the command line environment. And for instance, when it came to Yuri, so the people are using a lot of BLAT, so the BLAST like local alignment, and yeah, it's really running command line. So this is how it looks like. So you run BLAT, and then you type in the parameters, input the parameters, and a lot of the parameters you have to set. So it would be good to design a user interface for that. So you have your something to select your FASTFile, and then select the reference sequence, and then yeah, just click and click. So that's what most people wanted. And that's actually what Galaxy does. So Galaxy is like a tool platform to really that enables wrapping those command line software so that they can have like this user interface. So as you can see, we have here BLAT, and then you have your parameters there, but it's not command line anymore. It has this buttons that the researchers can click. So and analyses are often sequential, so you don't just wrap one tool, so you really wrap other tools. So commonly you have like I have this software that uses this input, and then it outputs a certain format, and then another software would hit that output from the first software, and then you have to like reformat that tool again to satisfy the second software, and so on and so forth. So basically that's how the typical use case would go. And so Galaxy offers that feature. So it allows you to graphically create workflows. So you have your list of tools, and then I can just like select what tool I want, and then I can make a pipeline. So Rice Galaxy is actually developed for computational biomedical research, and so it's here. It's a web-based platform for accessible, reproducible, and inspired computational biomedical research. So accessible, you don't need to have like programming experience to use these tools, and it's reproducible and it's transparent. You can save and share those analyses that you have. So and yeah, so this things in Galaxy, so you can have that. So it's like you have your tools, you have this history, which you can save your data sets here, and then yeah, just run your analysis. So it's good for us. And so we adapted Galaxy to have our own instance in here. So we have the Rice Galaxy, which caters basically tools that we use mostly for Rice research or Rice analysis. So we have the bioinformatic tools, the data sets, and then the workflows that we have. And we have collaborated with IRB and CERAD in France, in the Ball State University, Texas A&M, Indiana University, and AASB. So we have this Rice Galaxy. So it's here, galaxy.org. And yeah, so as that we had. And we also submitted it in Nature. So we have the data, but a lot of people cannot use it because it's really very big. So we have them in Galaxy. And we put the data set in Rise Galaxy so that users could access it. Or if they just want a subset of the 3K VCM, or they just want to subset markers and then samples so they can use it. And we also have the Rise. This is the Hydra is for the Hydra is a high density Rise array. So we have this chips from Illumina. This is a 700K SNP chip. Most people use it for genome-wide association studies. So we have the genotype in Galaxy, and then they bring in your phenotypes and then do the association analysis. And then we also have that should be 9, sorry. So the 9 other published Rise genomes and annotations. Okay, so these are the tools that we have in Galaxy. So we have the TK, R3, and Rise genomes and hybrid toolkit. So we have it here, that data. So we are using the Amazon SQ API to get our subset VCF from the Amazon SQ buckets. And then we also have the same data tools, so most people use it for like leftover. If they wanted to get the genes from a reference, and then do I have these genes in another reference? So these are the tools that most researchers use. And then we also have we run Basel, so we are using, most people use the association tools for using TASA. And then we also have the genomic prediction for OGMA. We call it the OGMA tool suite. So, and then, so this the OGMA tool suite is a set of tools that we develop to decipher the genotypes, to understand how it affects the phenotypes in rice using machine learning algorithms. So this is a typical workflow, how the genomic prediction works. So you have your genotype, so it could be from the 3K, or it could be from the Hydra, and then you encode. And then you have the genotype for training, and then you encode, and then you have your phenotypes. So you could choose from classifiers in OGMA, so let's say LASSO or Random Forest, SVM or R-Block, and then you do the predictions, and then you get your predicted values. So this is how it looks like in the Rise Galaxy. So this is the workflow for genomic prediction. And Galaxy is a federated instance, a multi-federated instance, because we collaborate with Southgate platform. So they have this their Rise variant analysis tool suite. And this is actually we use it for extracting markers or data set from the 3K databases. And I've been talking about this. The basic use case we get is like, I have this Rise gene in Nikon bar reference, and do I have this in IRA? So this is the algorithm or the step-by-step way to do it. So you get first a gene sequence from Nikon bar, and then you align it to another reference genome. For instance, here IRA, and then you post-process a lot of the things. Would be in post-processing, and then you extract the leftover sequences. Now you have your gene in IRA. Okay, so this is how it looks like. So that's the steep leftover workflow. So we also collaborated with open access compliance that we follow because we are under CGIAR. So we collaborated with the AASD in Japan. So the goal is to whenever you persistent identifier. So this must be globally unique. And yeah, we have this in tables in MongoDB. We have this in entries in MongoDB. So we also have the Rise Galaxy version. So we want the Galaxy community to use the tools. So if they have their data sets and then they wanted to use the tools, then people could use it. And then we also want to enrich this tool shed by hosting other researchers with other tools from other researchers in the RISE community. So this is where you can find the RISE Galaxy tool shed. So RISE Galaxy is a federated Galaxy resource tailored for RISE genetics, genomics, and breeding, and it integrates publicly available data sets and tools from other researchers in the RISE community. So these are my co-authors, and David, and DOS, as well. So they were very